Okay, and we are live. It is Tuesday night. It is 9 p.m. and that means it is time for Tuesday Night Perry. Tonight we're doing something a little different. Usually it's monster trucks, it's wrestling, it's in-person streams. Tonight I'm gonna be playing some retro side scrollers, some stuff that's really old, some stuff that's a little bit less old. But all kind of on the same spectrum of old school Sega Genesis, NES, Super NES, all kind of looking games. A couple are a bit newer. They're kind of new adaptations of old stuff. But we're going to start with, excuse me, we're going to start with one of the oldest here. As far as I know, this game is from 1988. It was originally put together for Commodore 64 and MS-DOS. Hey, Joey Nails, all up in the house. Good to see you, bud. Welcome. We're kicking things off here with some super old school. Wait till you see how old school this is. It's so old school, I couldn't find a proper ROM to run in my emulator. I'm running this on classicreload.com. This is the Commodore 64 version of Usagi Yojimbo from 1988. So we're going to kick off with that. This is super brief. I watched a playthrough of this. Some people it takes them 10 minutes and they're not even doing a speed run. And for all I know, it's not even going to work that well. In my tests, it was iffy. But we gotta fire it up. It's got some great audio. I've got the desktop audio up a little bit higher today because the games we're playing have some great soundtracks, and I don't think any of it's going to get me. At least not till the very end. I don't think any of it should get me any copyright strikes. So we're gonna play it by ear, but this is gonna be a different stream with a way different energy. And I've been. Oh yeah. That's my jams. Speaking of, we got retro old school stuff here. We got old school 80s music. They got the demo playing there while that's running. I've been having toys accompany me every week. I got the old New Kid on the Block figures, little Donnie Wahlberg there. I'm here in Massachusetts. I'm a Massachusetts boy. I grew up on the New Kids, man. It did lead me down the rabbit hole, forgive the pun, playing Usagi Yojimbo here. I did try to look up if there was ever a New Kids game, and it looks like there was almost one made, but they never finished. Very regretful about that. All right, let's just see. Okay, so I am in control here. Looks like I can do sort of like a Tai Chi pose. Okay, I can do it in either direction. That's what all my buttons do. If I hit the up button, I'd. Whoa, it didn't like that button. Okay, I can't do it and attack, so I can. Oh, I can kind of hop if I hit forward and up at the same time. All right, well, let's keep wandering here and see what happens. So far, I'm walking by some shrubs. Don't know, pretty serene if nothing else. The music rules. Now, I saw the demo and it looked like there's playing to be done. The only rabbit I care about is Cinnamoroll. This is where our age gap is very different, sir. All right, let's see. So we did a little, I guess that maybe that was practice. I'm gonna whack F7 and see if it actually puts us in and there's like gonna be some enemies or something, because all that did was walk across the screen. And if that's all that ends up happening, we're gonna move on to the next game. It might be that MS-DOS slash Commodore 64 1988 Usagi Yojimbo is maybe not going to happen for us, which is okay. It's okay. I've prepped a few other games. I think I have four other games to play through. We are going to stick with Usagi Yojimbo at the beginning. Yeah, I think this little test thing is just not going to do anything for us. All right. Given that, I've switched to my big view here. Joey Nails, not gonna lie, it's gonna be weird to watch your videos of these streams years from now and see a 19-year-old me bully you. Hey, thankfully you're not on screen, so we're not going to see you bully me. We're just going to be aware that it happened. The future will judge you harshly. And remember, the Aquabats are seriously the best band in the world. All right. So that was not going to cut it for us. So I'm gonna pop open my emulator here. And we're going to go to, you know what? We're not gonna pop open the emulator yet. First of all, while I'm on the bigger screen, let's get the boys up here, huh? Huh? That's right. We got Donnie, Danny, Jonathan, Joey, and Jordan. New Kids on the Block hanging out while I play some retro stuff. Herobotic showed up just as the 1988 Commodore 64 Usagi Yojimbo proved to be worthless for us. So instead, we are jumping ahead to, I believe, 2016 for the release of Usagi Yojimbo Way of the Ronin. This game, you will notice immediately, is a port from mobile, which is never a good sign. We've done some mobile ports on the channel before. I dig the music. Great theme. The art doesn't even bother me. The fact that I have to use the mouse is a little bit suspect. But we're gonna zip through a bit of this, and then I got more games lined up, because we're doing old school side scrollers tonight. Alright, we're playing. Here we go. Stan Sakai, the creator of Usagi Yojimbo. No more ads for a month for Herobotic. Joey Nails coming in clutch. You are our faithful servant. You have rid the world of much evil. But it goes slowly, too slowly. Whoa, I mean, I'm trying, man. This is J-E-I. I have a little character guide up on my other screen. Old ones are trapped, and then you will free them. But first, you must find and destroy the mirror. It's the only thing they fear. Okay, this rules. How do I find the mirror? No longer lost at the bottom of the sea. Well, that's good. That would have been hard. Priests have been holding it and... Damn priests. We will show you where the mirror is hidden. And what of those who stand in my way? You will have help. Huh? Ah, the yokai! Dude, this rules. If you guys haven't seen the Usagi Yojimbo series that came out on Netflix... You will love it. Oh, Herobotic's gonna end up dipping early because of allergies. Yo, I feel it. You can probably hear it in my voice a little. But you'll want to catch the replay on YouTube, because I'm doing some... I got some games on here that would pop you. Is he a TMNT character, Usagi? So sort of. Usagi Yojimbo is in the TMNT canon. He's appeared in every series they've ever done. I don't think he's made it into any of the movies. Yes, I know. The controls in this are wonky and weird. Hey, there goes Takoge. That's his pet dinosaur lizard. I'm not really entirely sure what he is. But the Usagi series, I think it has two seasons, that's on Netflix, is excellent. Yeah, that's right. He started as his own series by Stan Sakai, who still draws him to this day. It has a great series, and they do crossovers all the time. He really is one of my favorite, like, of those not quite Ninja Turtle characters. There's characters that are adjacent, and we're going to be seeing that whole world of, like, late 80s, early 90s comic book meets cartoon characters is really the thing for me. Oh, Stan Sakai is still alive, still does meet and greets. He's got a great Instagram feed you can follow. We're gonna see some more of those later. All right, here we go. Greetings, I am Miyamoto Usagi. Ah, that's right, the original Usagi Yojimbo. Because the series on Netflix is his great-grandson. And it's a great... If you look up Usagi Yojimbo on Netflix, you'll find it right away. Before I left for Japan, I actually watched the whole series on the treadmill when I was doing cardio. What seems to be the problem here? Please help us, kind samurai. Whoa, those guys headed for the hills. Stand aside, Ronin. We have business with these peasants. Business? Looks like you mean them harm. That is our business, and you're our next customer. That's a pretty good line. That's not a bad line. All right. Okay, yeah, this definitely reads as a ported from mobile game. Oh. Thank you, samurai. They would have killed us. Why were those men... I was just going to ask, why were they after you? I saw them attack a priest just down the road. These bandits don't leave witnesses. Whoa. They mean business. There are more bandits back there. Many more. Local village is a haven for thieves, a wretched hive of scum and villainy. I'll take my chances. That's right. Soggy's not afraid. Okay. Well, I guess I'm stealing from the people I killed. Okay. Yeah, what's in here? Use this combo. Press jump button or space bar twice. Well, it's not going to be the space bar. It's called Rabbit's Journey. Is that what it's called? I believe it's the Usagi Chronicles or something like that. You know, Herobotic, anything can be a sex toy if it's used properly or improperly, as it were. Okay, I guess I can't go much... Whoa, hey! It wouldn't let me go any further. I had to get shot at. Use the power to... Yeah, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to keep swinging my sword, man. Like, this game ain't that complicated. I don't need special attacks. Hey, I wanted that coin. Oh, they're bothering a priest. I'm conflicted. If you're brave enough. That's right. Oh my god, they got him. What the heck? Whoa. Guys. What do you have for us? Oh, I got a sword. You might like that. Yeah. Literally, oh, a boss. Okay. Oh, he's a yokai. Let's go. The yokai play heavily in the series on Netflix. Mirror was just here. I smell it. Whoa, I missed it? Oh, I don't know what it is, apparently. Well, that wasn't a very difficult boss. Whoa, look at all those coins. He's badly wounded. Here, let me take that money. I have to get you to a healer. My life doesn't matter. Ronin, you must retrieve the mirror I carried. The shrine was attacked by a swarm of yokai monsters trying to destroy it. I slipped away to keep it safe, but now it has been stolen by bandits. So I found out today that the Steamboat Willow Horror movie will be screamed. Oh, it's written by a friend of yours. That rules. Oh, that's awesome. Everything that gets public domain has to be made into a horror movie, I guess. That's like a rule now. It'll be Gilbert in the house. That's right, Tuesday Night Perry. We're playing some... old school side scrollers. This one less old school, but based on an old school character. It does rule. Gotta go day one. Hell yeah, man. If it's playing somewhere out here, I'll go with you. If it's at the Amherst Cinema or something, we'll hit it up. Yeah, playing some Usagi Yojimbo. This was a mobile game that came out in 2016 based on, of course, the 80s comic book character. Oh no. Oh no. I was unable to save that man. Yeah. Use this combo. Yeah, sure. Whatever you want. I don't care about the combos. Next level. That's how people describe me. They always say, Perry, he's next level. Joey Nails, can I come? It's far away, man. You got a long drive to get down here. Now that you've gifted me a sub, I don't know how I can say. Well, that's true. I guess it's your robotics outing. He gets to make the call. Oh, this. Oh, crap. What is this guy's name? He plays prominently in the cartoon series too. Oh man. Okay. I'm not gonna click off the game because that makes it go away because it's one of these crappy ports. But I was forced to go to the store with my. Oh, Bobby Glover coming in late. Had to make a run out to the store. I mean, that's tough. But hey, you made it. You're hanging tough, just like Donnie Wahlberg. Danny Wood. That's right. I got all the new kids here. Jonathan Knight. I'm going to do this every so often. We got Jordan. And of course, Joey Mack, the original little Joey. Again, what brings you here? Oh, that's right. That's his name. Have you seen the criminals in this village? Just on the street outside, I spotted three people on my list of bounties. I'll clean up here. Someone has made this town very unfriendly for thieves, or very friendly for thieves and murderers. You should quiet down about the bounties. Yeah, probably maybe don't mention it. Hey, you two. Did I hear right? You're bounty hunters? Yeah, I guess he said it too much. Oh, Bobby's still at the store. He's walking around just showing random people my live stream, and they're like, why are you watching a guy play Usagi Yojimbo and play with New Kids toys? They got to be really confused. You know what we do to bounty hunters in this village? Doesn't look inviting. Get him. All right, let's go. Hey. You guys, come on. We got him. We got him again. He is not helpful. He's just walking around, lurching about. How do the villagers live with all of this? That's a real good question. We've been here like a couple minutes and we're getting attacked. They're caught in the middle. Look at it this way. Every criminal we bring down is one less threat to the villagers. Hey, you know, we're nice guys now that they mention it. I'm actually looking for a stolen mirror, not bounties. Look, I'll buy you a mirror once we've cashed in. The writing in this game is not bad. Like, this is actually pretty funny stuff, considering it's like a crappy mobile game. Go down this road, you go off that way. Oh, okay, we're splitting up apparently. That way we don't have to split our bounties. Hey! Street performer stole my money. She was a main character. That's Kitsune. She's in the Netflix series. Oh, this rules. I'll have your head. I'm sure you're mistaken. She was a lot shorter in the Netflix series. She's like a little short character. This one, she's like taller than Usagi, maybe. Kitsune, Usagi, wonderful timing. Let me introduce you. Overly muscled lout, meet Usagi. Usagi, meet lout. This is great writing. Like, this is really good. Joey, we'll talk. We'll see, because I don't necessarily know how to do that very well. But I have some ideas. Message me. Don't let me forget, like you did with the match critiques. I'll kill you both. Okay, all right, fella. Calm down. Oh, jeez. Was that one guy a walrus? So, did you really steal that man's pouch? Of course she did. The girl has to do what she can to get by, right? Besides, he stole it from someone else. The whole village is like that. Sounds like a place one might bring valuable loot to sell. Like a mirror? If someone stole something really valuable, they would take it to Boss Soshi. Soshi is in Lord Hebi's pocket, so he has money and protection. I'll show you where he lives. Hey, thanks. Oh, I wanted to break open that crate and get what was inside. And they just sent him a doc that said quit the business. That's more like what Rip would have written, but Rip saw that I'd already written a lot of thoughtful critique, so he decided to be nice. Is that Boss Soshi's house? What clued you in? The size of the house or all of the guards? Hey, why are you two sneaking around? I mean, we never were really sneaking, we just kind of walked right up. I need to speak to Boss Soshi about a stolen mirror. You got something to sell? No? Here to reclaim something wrongfully taken from a priest. Everything here is the rightful property of Boss Soshi. And anyone who says different gets to taste my sword. Alright guys, let's everybody be cool. Just gonna go ahead and get that life. Yeah, you can really tell this is a port from a mobile game. Like, this reads like an iPhone game. So, you're the Ronin that's been causing all this trouble. Yeah, you could say that. We don't need to fight. Just let me in. You're Soggy, right? I hear you're a talented swordsman. It'll be an honor to defeat you. Look, man, if how I've done against all the rest of these is any indication. And after that, I can charge double for my services. Well, you will try. Wow, he's, just like that, huh? This game's really violent. Like, there's a lot of people that die. Kind of crazy. There are even more guards inside. Of course there are. Of course there's more. You sure you need this mirror that badly? I think the mirror I'm after is important somehow. He thinks the mirror is important somehow. All this killing for something that he thinks is important. And I made a promise. Then there's no talking you out of it. That promise didn't include me throwing my life away too, did it? No, I better go alone. Try to stay out of trouble, Kitsune. She never stays out of trouble. She's a troublemaker, even in the cartoon. All right, let's see. What time is it? We got 9:25. All right. So I'm going to call it on this Usagi game because we got more to view. And I'm going to come back to this in a future stream. We're just going to go through the whole game and beat it all at once. But for now, we're going to call that. I'm going to pop over here. We're going to go to the close-up cam. Kill that off. All right. Now we're hopping into my emulator where we are. I guess that's the one. All right. Popping back over here. There we go. We are firing up some Toxic Crusaders from 1992 on the Sega Genesis. That's right. Kicking it old school. And I'm psyched for this. Joey Mack is psyched too. Look at the green screen's working funny with him. All right, it went into demo mode because I was dancing too long. Yes, 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 we know. It's a trademark of Troma Inc. Yes, yes, yes. Very good. Sega. Look at Tromaville. It's beautiful. I really hope they release that new Toxie movie with Peter Dinklage. Oh, that would be so sick. I'm sure you know. We're going to get to it, but there is a new Toxic Crusaders game. It's not out yet, but when we're done with this, we're going to play the demo. So I'm on my way to hang out with my blonde babe Yvonne when these whacked out troopers in these crazy getups drop out of the sky and ruin my day. If these garbage slinging chumps think they're going to trash Tromaville, and I didn't read it fast enough, but you get the idea. It's Toxie being Toxie. He's always kind of like that. Whoa. Okay, all right. I've not taken care of a single one of these guys yet. This game plays really fast. I'm not totally sure. Oh, well, I got hit by the car. How do we get back on? Yeah, there we go. Hey, I got my little sludgy guy on my shoulder. That rules. Oh, man, come on. I want to know because I know Hero Botic played this. Is this how you remember the game? It's definitely get ready. Oh, I'm ready. I'm just not good at any game, so. I mean, I'm just here for the nostalgia. I could be terrible at this, and I am. It's not going to bother me. I do absolutely love the way that all these games, these cartoons, these characters are all designed with one thing in mind, and it's how to sell the toys. Man, keep shooting me. I would never expect a trauma-based game to be of any quality at all. Well, I will say, all right, so I'm dead there. And I'm gonna say I'm terrible at this one. So we may keep this one real brief, and I'm just gonna let that be the game over, because I wanna try the new one. Because the new one is made, as I understand it, by the same folks that made Shredder's Revenge. So I'm gonna pop back to my close-up here. We're gonna get the new one up right now. You can tell I haven't fired it up in a while. It's going slow. Already this is amazing. This is it's the old theme song. Look, Jordan's all about it. All right, let's oh, this is so sick. So just a heads, Yvonne with her accordion in the background. Let's go. I will say, this demo is free on Steam. So if you like what you see and you want to play through it one time on your own, something to think about. All right, we're gonna hop right in because, I came all this way. Oh, it's gonna have multiplayer. Yo, we all get this on Steam and we take at it like an arcade game. And let's see. Okay, so you can play as Toxie. Apparently you can't play as No Zone. We got this is hang on, I have my character guide over on my other thing and I always forget who everyone is. Major Disaster. We got Junkyard. We can't play as it's two characters, Headbanger. We can play as Yvonne, we can't play as Toxie's mom just yet. But yo, considering this is like just a demo and they have all these characters you can play as. All right, I mean, obviously we're playing as Toxie, right? Like, oh man, dude, this is already so sick. I'm so psyched about this.
Gee, fellas, Dr. Killamoff finally pulled out all the stops. Seeing as no one else...
I'm turning the volume up a little.
...is available, this looks like a job for the Toxic Crusaders.
I'm going to get rid of the ticker for a minute, too, because they keep having text on the bottom. Tromaville, let's go. Oh, so great. Hey, what? Oh, she's running through something. Okay, hey, whoa. Guys, what's... Uh-oh. These are definitely some of Dr. Killamoff's people. Dr. Killamoff? Yeah, it's Killamoff. I had it on the first time. Gotta go with the original. Yeah, of course. But let's, what happens if I hit this? Yeah. Ooh. Whoa, okay, alright. We're going a little Terry Funk Mick Foley style here. Take that. What was the name of the evil corporation in this? That was devastating Tromaville through the movies and the cartoon. Herobotics got the best chance of remembering.
I enjoy a walk as much as the next hideously deformed canine, but something about the scenery today leaves a lot to be desired.
Now, Junkyard, let's not be harsh. The Tromaville Civic Association put a lot of care into their high street restoration project. It's not their fault an army of alien interlopers decided to trample all over it.
Yeah, when I mark my territory, it's cute, but when these bozos do it, it's just plain rude.
This is amazing. Yes, it was Apocalypse Inc. All the talkie bits that come in with the character voices and stuff, this is killing me. This is so good. Apparently, I can just pick up cars to chuck at people. It just knocked him over. Oh, I can body slam them, just like he did in the movie. This is so sick. The full version of this game is supposed to be out sometime this fall. They haven't announced an official date, but fall is what they've sort of said. Oh, that kid's got a weapon. I don't like that. Come here, you. You're causing trouble. Oh, hey, whoa. You citizens of Tromaville, okay? I love that you can pick them up and throw them at each other. The sound effects are very trauma. A little hard to hear me with the music. Okay, I can make an adjustment to that. I had the game up way high because there were the little vocals that are happening over it, but I can only get my mic up so high, so, you know, working with what I got here. Oh, okay, all right.
An invasion? I've seen miracles with more military might.
You're telling me, even when I worked for these guys, they were useless. And don't get me started on the office parties.
Oh, yeah. I forget. You used to be one of the bad guys. Glad you saw the light of day.
What can I say? You've grown on me.
This is great. This does feel like the Turtles games. But like, you know, kind of the same way that the movies did, it feels just like weirder. Yeah, I think having a bunch of other other trauma references spread throughout would be awesome. Well, what do we got here? He's hitting me with a flamethrower. Are you kidding me right now? Come on. Okay, so this so far for me is the highlight of the stream. Like, this is the best thing. Tromeo and Juliet. I've got so much more trauma I need to see. Like, I watched the first two Toxies in full, and I really, the last Toxie 3, I really only made it like a third of the way through. I was like, I can't do this. He's joining the bad guys in the first 10 minutes. It was weird.
Hey, where'd everybody go?
It's Headbanger.
Looks like you're heading into that diner for a bite to eat. An army marches on its stomach, after all.
Oh, wow, dinner time. Do you think they allow dogs?
Are we gonna fight in the restaurant?
They're trashing the place. Not cool, Bugkids.
Not cool indeed, Fender. Disorderly conduct is one thing, but trashing a small business outside of a public holiday? That's un-American.
Outside of a public holiday. Yeah, that's true. That's sort of like a trademark of trauma is, you know, it's there's a pretty good chance it's going to be terrible, and there's a pretty good chance it'll be amazing. And the line between the two is very hard to see. Like, sometimes even while you're watching the film. Like, my thought right at the beginning of Toxie 2 was that it was going to be terrible, and I wound up loving it. Now, admittedly, I myself had just come back from being a giant mutant in Japan, so it's possible that, you know, I was a little... Yeah, take... Oh, I threw it the wrong way. I love that the voices in this sound like the Ninja Turtles.
All kinds of assumptions about your sanity.
Brilliant name for a Mexican restaurant. It's just the Mexican place. Oh, what do we got here? Thugs in there. Their boss man. Oh, I remember him from the movies, I think. Frank. Yeah, Frank. It's up on the screen.
Had to get these guys there just to start.
Just as long as they finish their vegetables first. Yeah.
Ooh, and then maybe they can visit the salad bar.
Easy now. Let's not wear out the joke.
I don't know if the voiceovers are coming through as clear for you guys as they are for me. But this, like the Usagi game, great writing. Like, it's like properly funny. BG Whip. Okay, I get the name. Yep. I remember her from the movies too. Oh boy, I'm about keeled over here. Oh, I needed that turkey in the top corner. Yeah. Yeah, Frank just punching down a wall. That's very trauma as well. I mean, this entire fight happening in a random Mexican restaurant is also very trauma. Tell him no zone.
Matters these days.
After them, fellas. We still need to split the check. Superheroes aren't made of money, you know.
This is just the demo. There's so much here. Take it easy, Herobotic. I hope you enjoyed, because this has been amazing. Is this her again? I just defeated her. Why is she here? This game rules. I can't tell you how much totally excited I am for the full release. What really sold me is the body slams. Like, it's such a way that Toxie totally fought in the movies.
Our home? This time you've gone too far, Killamon.
They're in my home in the dump.
I know, but a man's dump is his castle. This is personal.
Jesus, guys, everybody be cool. Holy crap. Dr. Kill-em-off.
Kill-em-off. Attacking the good people of Tromaville is one thing, but trespassing on our toxic waste dump? Where's your sense of decency?
And smell.
Decency's got nothing to do with it. I'm just finishing what I started years. I mean, days ago. Psycho, launch the weapon.
You got it, boss.
The new kids agree.
To this ridiculous charade, and the only ones trespassing here are you on my planet.
This is so great.
It's Pluto.
What? Let's go. Look at how long his life bar is. It goes all the way across the bottom of the screen. How many of these Rad Rangers are gonna keep showing up? Good thing I seem to have unlimited lives in this, because I would be toast otherwise. Baluda's got a lot of life here. One thing I've been terrible at in this is like stringing combos together. It's just random swipes. Like I'm just smashing and bashes. You know, there's no technique involved here. There we go.
Take that, you overgrown oil spill.
Yeah, take a hike, kill him off. The only thing slick around here is the beatdown we just dished out.
Excellent work, Toxic Crusaders, and excellent wordplay. It's days like these that make me proud to be a hideously deformed creature of superhuman size and strength.
Let's go. Is that going to be all we get, or is there more? It's hard to tell with a demo. Like, they kind of just gave us an entire level for free. Like, this was free. It says loading. It's right behind me there. Danny's waiting. Donnie's waiting. Joey Joe. He's waiting. Everybody's waiting.
No!
Here we go.
Who could have possibly seen this coming?
Told you so.
What was that?
Nothing, boss. Say, isn't that Zazoster calling?
Get him up, coming, you idiot! What's this I'm hearing about Paluto getting blown up? He's got the sentient oil slicks grow on trees, you know.
Well, actually, a foul is if our master plan comes to fruition, they just might.
No thanks to you, Kilimov. It's my master plan, not yours. Now don't you have another level to disappoint me on?
Yes, of course, Azostar. We were just, heading there now. Although that's a little harsh, perhaps.
Hey, he's getting away! And before we could bring him to justice for all his evil schemes and stuff.
Don't sweat it, Nozone. Looks like Kilimov's heading into the Tromaville Health Club. We can bring him to justice and work on our glutes at the same time!
You leave my glute out of this!
Good thinking, Fender. A healthy planet starts with a healthy body, as I always say. Come on, Toxic Crusaders! It's shape-up time!
That was rad. I love that the next level is going to be the Tromaville Health Club, because for those who've seen the Toxic Avenger movies and Toxic Crusader, his whole story starts in the Tromaville Health Club. Okay, so that was totally rad. I loved that. That's amazing. All right, I'm going to switch back to the close-up cam. And we're going to come over here and I'm going to bail out of that. I'm going to throw open my emulator again because we got one more game. We got one more game lined up before we call tonight. I'm going to play a little bit on it. I doubt very much I'll get all the way through it, but it's going to be a blast. I'm very excited for this one. We got Michael Jackson's Moonwalker. All right, here we go. The co-stars, the new kids on the block, they know that you gotta respect MJ. Sega. Baby, that's what I'm talking about. Man, I could just listen to the music.
Michael.
And to save some kid. that rules. Okay. Yo, this music is killing it. Jumped on the piano, it made noise. You've been struck by a smooth criminal. Get out of here, kid. Did I just do a little crouch grab? I did. It's like a sign of dominance. Oh, they shot me. I don't remember that happening in the Moonwalk movie. Moonwalker movie. Alright, we're gonna give it another try. Suddenly there's extra stairs. And my energy got way down there. They ate me up. Grizzly Raid, the Grizz Crew coming in. We've been playing some retro side scrollers. We started with some Usagi Yojimbo. We moved on to the original Toxic Crusaders game for the Sega Genesis from 1992, and then we played a bit of the demo for the upcoming. Oh, I see. I've only got so much. I'm still learning how this game works exactly. But yeah, now we're playing some Michael Jackson Moonwalker. And I've not been very good at this, I'm gonna say. But the Toxic Avenger games were really good. And especially the demo for the new one that's coming out. Getting killed in this one. I'm so bad at it. Oh, there's evil Joe Pesci laughing at me because I got a game over. But yeah, the new Toxic Avenger game is going to be so sick. That's been the highlight of the stream for me. Yeah, I want to continue. Why not? Came all this way. We're going to give this one a few more tries here. And there's other music you can pick from in this game. Nice, we're playing some Captain Planet on the Genesis. Went on YouTube and done some. Oh, okay, that's awesome. Yeah, man, Captain Planet's one I should put on the list. I'm not great at most games, but, I'm also willing to be bad at them. Like, I don't mind if I'm terrible at them, because I know, generally speaking, that's just how it's going to go. criminal. Ah, suddenly I got a bunch of health back. I wonder what I did. Am I supposed to do something else here? I feel like I've kind of defeated all the people. Okay, can't go through the doors. Oh, maybe I can. Okay, I figured out how to open a door. And then I got punched in the face. Yeah, man, these old side-scrollers are hard. I will say, I said it before, that new Toxic Avengers game. If you have the time and you have a way, the demo, the first level, is free on Steam because the game's not out yet. I just had such a blast playing through it. Like, if you've ever seen, like, the Toxic Avenger movies, or you remember Toxic Crusader from back in the day, like, this game is absolutely a love letter to that stuff. It was super fun. Had an absolute blast playing it. Especially since, oh hey, I can slide down the rail. That's neat. I just watched those movies and the cartoon, really, for the first time. In the last couple of months here, I was this one dude just comes out and shoots me. That's, I don't understand. You know, look, I'm not gonna claim that I'm good at this and I deserve to be beating it, but I feel like it's a little unfair. How is the Captain Planet game though? Is it fun? Like, because if a theme song is in there, then I'm sold. That's really all it takes for me. The theme song to that, which most people don't even realize, is basically the same song as Step by Step by the New Kids on the Block. Speaking of, the New Kids on the Block have been my co-hosts tonight. There's no one attacking me at the moment, so I'm just gonna. I got the whole crew here. You know, I'm such a 90s toy guy that, you know, when I saw, ooh, heck of a dance move. I keep getting shot. But yeah, when I saw those, Joe Pesci got me. He got me good. Look at him mocking me and laughing at me. Unbelievable. All right, I'm gonna say no new game. And I've been pushing it on this stream. I'm gonna call it for tonight. This one's gonna be a little bit short. It's so hard. I think it's an 8-bit version of the song. I'm into that. That rules. Chiptune stuff is some of my favorite. But I'm actually gonna call it a stream there. This was game number 5 of the stream, so flew through a lot, flew through it pretty quick, but that was what this stream was going to be all along. It was a lot of... Sorry, that animation just got me. That's what it was going to be all along. So thanks everybody for tuning in and hanging out and checking out the stream. I will be back again next week, Monday and Tuesday, 9 p.m., right here on twitch.tv/ParryVonVicious. Have a great night. Thanks for coming by.